We're going to solve this equation, which is quadratic in form. Remember, to solve quadratic equations that are quadratic in form, we're going to do a little u substitution. For instance, if we have ax plus 1 squared plus b times x plus 1 to the first plus c, that's quadratic in form because I could rewrite that x plus 1 as u, and that would be a u squared plus b u plus c. And that's what we're going to do on this video. We're going to have an example like this. So here's the problem. And notice in parentheses I have x squared minus 2x. And over here I have it again, but it's squared. So it's natural that it looks sort of like u squared minus 11u plus 24. So that's exactly what we're going to do. We're going to say, how about if we call u x squared minus 2x, and now I could replace this x squared minus 2x with just the letter u. So I have u squared minus 11u plus 24 equals 0, and now it's not so difficult. It's a quadratic equation now, and it's not too difficult to factor. U minus 8, u minus 3 equals 0. And then we set each factor equal to 0 and solve. So you should get u equals 8 or u equals 3. Now remember, we're trying to solve for x. We have to think of the original problem, which is in red up here. So now I have to replace u with what it really stands for, right? U really stands for x squared minus 2x. So I'm going to replace the u with x squared minus 2x, okay? Equals 8, or replace it over here, x squared minus 2x equals 3, and now I'm going to solve for x, okay? Well, you know what? Here's another quadratic equation. You set it equal to 0 and factor. Same thing over here. Set it equal to 0 and factor. All right, now we're going to take each factor and set it equal to 0, and hopefully you can see that the solutions look like they're going to be 4, negative 2, 3, and negative 1. It's just a list of numbers. You could put them in numerical order from smallest to largest or largest to smallest, but I just put them in order as I happen to write them here. So looks like this has 4 solutions, which of course we have to check. By the way, the original equation up here, you could have gone ahead and squared that binomial and did the distributive property and combined all the like terms, and you would have something looking a little bit different, which would be harder to solve. So this u substitution actually makes it easier. So let's go ahead and check each of these solutions in the original problem. Okay, before you just sit and watch me do all the work, how about you turning off the video and trying each of these? First, check to make sure 4 is a solution by plugging in 4. Make sure you get 0 on both sides. Then redo it plugging in negative 2. Then redo it plugging in 3. Then redo it and plug in negative 1. Okay, so here we go. We're going to plug in 4 for x. So I have 4 squared minus 2 times 4, and that whole thing squared. And then I'm going to put 4 squared minus 2 times 4. And I'm going to add 24. And we're going to simplify that. Okay, so I have to simplify in the parentheses. That's going to be 16 minus 8, so that's 8 squared. And then here in parentheses, I'm going to get 16 minus 8 again, so that's 8. So I have 64 minus 88 plus 24, and that's 0. So 4 checks, that's the solution. All right, now let's do negative 2. We're going to plug in negative 2 for x. And I'm going to get it again. You know what? Whatever's in here is going to be exactly the same thing. I'm just going to use one color so it's faster. This takes more space, as you see, because I know there's a zero on the other side, because I'm plugging in negative two. All right, so what do I have inside this parentheses? I have four, and this is going to be a plus four, so that's going to be 8 squared. And I'm going to have the same thing here, right? Because I'm going to have 4 plus 4 in the parentheses. Oops, I noticed a mistake here. This was not squared. Okay. So we've got minus 11 times 8 plus 24. And notice I get 0 again. So negative 2 checks. That's the solution. All right, now we're on to 3. So 3 squared minus 2 times 3 squared minus 11. 3 squared minus 2 times 3 plus 24. So what do we have inside the parentheses here? We've got 9 minus 6, which is 3 squared, minus 11 times. Again, it's 9 minus 6, which is 3, plus 24. So I have 9 minus 33 plus 24, which is 0, and that checks. Whew. One more. It's the only way you're going to make sure. All right, so we're going to plug in again negative 1. So I have negative 1 squared minus 2 times negative 1, whole thing squared minus 11 times negative 1 squared minus 2 times negative 1. Oops, that looks like a negative 11. Plus 24. All right, so in this parentheses, I've got 1 plus 2, which is 3 squared. And again, I've got 1 plus 2, which is 3, plus 24. 9 minus 33, plus 24, 0. All four solutions check. You may have noticed that for two of them, you end up getting the same thing once you plug, you know, inside what's in that parentheses. But this is how you do need to check your work. So our solutions are 4, negative 2, 3, and negative 1. Now, let's say you didn't use that U substitution and you just tried squaring this binomial and combining like terms. This is what would happen. This is a binomial squared, so it's x squared minus 2x times x squared minus 2x, so you could do the FOIL method. This is going to be minus 11x squared plus 22x plus 24 equals 0. So when I square that binomial, I have x to the fourth minus 2x cubed minus another 2x cubed plus 4x squared minus 11x squared plus 22x plus 24 equals 0. And when you combine like terms, we have x to the fourth minus 4x cubed minus 7x squared plus 22x plus 24 equals 0. The problem is you don't know how to solve when you have something to the fourth power and then the third power squared x, etc. Something you might know if you've taken pre-calculus, or maybe algebra 2 trig in high school, but it's nothing that I've done on my videos yet. So the thing is, you would get stuck right here. But it is true that this equation has exactly the same solutions. So you can verify that you get exactly the same solutions. If you want, you could plug in 4 and see that this equation's true, or you could plug in negative 2, you could find out this equation's true, and 3 and negative 1, but you might not know how to get those yet. Okay, so that's why we did it by using this little U substitution. It's actually quicker and easier. You just get it down to a quadratic.